Let's start with creating a plugin from a Teams message extension. So I assume most people here are familiar with Teams message extensions, but in case you're not, these are apps that extend the conversational experience in Teams. So if you've ever used an interactive poll in a conversation, or maybe you've shared a link and it unfurled into like a rich adaptive card, that's a message extension. There are tens of thousands of message extensions in Teams app catalog today, and they're used by millions of users. And the good news is, if you already built a message extension, you already have a plugin. Copilot will know how to integrate your message extension on day one, so you're good to go. I was expecting a little different response there. I'll try it again. Yeah. It's just gonna work. We're just gonna make sure that works for you. And to see this in action, let's take a look at the Zoho plugin. So if you're not familiar, Zoho is a CRM tool, and it's used by customers around the world. They already have a message extension in the Teams app catalog. And as you can see here, Copilot was able to work with it and integrate with it as is. It just works. So now Zoho's users, once Copilot's available, will be able to create and manage their work items all from the same conversational experience. So let's say you were one of the folks here who maybe didn't clap at that last slide. Maybe you don't have a message extension. Maybe you don't want to create a message extension, that's fine. You can easily create a message extension starting from an API. There's three things you need to do for this. You need to build your API. You're going to want to document that API using the Open API specification. And then you need to create your app manifest. This document is going to instruct Copilot how to interact with your plugin. And we'll get a little more into what that means later. So let's demonstrate this. We're gonna switch over to a repairs service that I already built, and from that, we're going to create a plugin. So here's my repairs project. This is already built. I've already went ahead and documented this using the Open API specification. This is that open standard you've heard a lot about today. And let's just walk through it. So you can see the title of my repair service, a description. Here's URLs to my development server, my production server. Below here are all the paths. These are the capabilities that my API supports. Let's take a look at this first one, list repairs. So this list repairs skill, what it does is it returns a list of repairs with their details and images. To call it, there's one parameter, assigned to. So you would provide someone's name, and it will return a list of repairs assigned to that person. Below there, we have an explanation of how the responses are formatted when you call this API. And I do this for all the other skills supported, like create repair, and I have delete and update repair. Once you have your API built and it's documented in the Open API spec, that's the hard part. Next, you just have to create your plugin, create your app that you'll eventually publish to the Teams store. For this, I'm going to use the Teams Toolkit extension for VS Code. If you haven't used this, this is the easiest way to do this. And for this, I'm just going to invoke this extension. It's right over here. I already have it installed. Click on create a new app. You're going to see a new option up here, plugin for Copilot. Now I'm going to browse and select that Open API spec. This is going to provide a lot of the foundational information that will be used into my manifest. Now I'm going to select which skills from my Open API spec do I want to support in my plugin. I'm going to do list repairs and create repair. Click OK. Now I'm going to select the folder I want to store this in. Let's give it a name. We're going to call it repairs. And then you press enter. And just like that, the Teams toolkit's gonna go ahead and create my app. This is, as is, you can go start testing this and publish it. This is a plugin. It was very easy, but we'll take a look at what's in here. So let's start with the manifest. I mentioned earlier, this document is what Copilot uses to understand how your plugin works. So it's very important you make sure this is how you want it. Let's walk through the different fields here. So, you see here the name of my service. Most of this is coming from the Open API spec, by the way, so you'll see a lot of that. The description of my service. Then down here where I had paths before, these are now the commands for my plugin. So there's the list repairs command. It's a query. It's a description of what it does, the parameters it uses. And because the Open API spec describes the format of the response, we're even able to automatically generate those adaptive cards for you. We showed this in the earlier example as well. So this is what this would look like. So anytime a user asks to see a repair, this is how it will be returned to them. And then here you can make changes if you need to. You can say you want the image bigger. Make it however you'd like, and then once you're ready, test out your plugin and you're ready to publish it. That's it. So now let's take a look at how this actually works once we put it in Copilot. So you can see here, you can clap, go for it, yeah. It's really exciting stuff. So you can see here the plugin in action. Find me a repair assigned to Isaac. It's now gonna use that list repairs command that we just walked through. It's gonna go to the manifest, see that the parameter was it needed one assigned to field. It's gonna use Isaac's name, search the system for all repairs assigned to Isaac. Copilot will then return that along with the adaptive card we just looked at. So now we covered two different ways to create a plugin. Let's talk about some best practices when you do this. First and foremost, good descriptions. Your manifest lets Copilot know when and how and everything about your plugin. So it's really important that you describe it well. And for this, we mean like clear, concise descriptions. I'm sure folks here have used LLMs and worked with LLMs in the past, so you would know that prompt engineering is more of an art than it is a science. So test out different descriptions. Make sure your plugin works as you expect. This will make sure your users get the most out of it. Next, you're going to want to use an API manager. We recommend it. And I use the Azure API manager. This will let you govern your plugin so you can set some rate limits to make sure there's no unintended usage spikes of your plugin. And you can also monitor it in real time. So now we all see how easy it is to make these plugins. It's going to be simple and they're very powerful. It's going to change the way we all work. Although Copilot is not available today, you can still get ahead by building your message extension. If you have a message extension in our store, once Copilot is available, it's just going to work. So go ahead and build one. And also, we're going to have a wait list. There's a link there. I think we just set this up like yesterday. So join that, and you'll be one of the first ones on that. And this will give you access to plugins as soon as they become available.